Welcome back to Movie On. Today I'm going to explain the movie called The Sleeping Dictionary from 2003. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. And I hope you enjoy it. An English officer was traveling to a distant place. To learn the local language of that place, he was accompanied by a girl. She will have sex with him and teach him their language. But the problem occurred when he fell in love with her. To know what happens next, keep watching the video. The story started in 1936. Then, England had their reign over so many countries. Whoever wanted to join any government job was sent to remote areas for their education. There, they would do everything with them, and when they came back, they would join the job. The main character of this movie is John. He went to Sarawak to study. This country was not so developed. So many people didn't even know his language. When John came there, a guy who knew his language came to greet him. Then he took John to his office. His name was Henry, and Henry was staying here for so long. Henry asked him, "You have had so many options, so why did you choose this place?" John said, "My father served here. He wanted to educate these people, and he wants to complete his father's mission." Henry told him, "You will not succeed. People here are so different. There's no benefit in teaching these people." Then Henry took him to meet the head of the local tribe. Henry told John, "Whatever he says, you'll have to do it." They gave him a drink. John does not drink, but it would be disrespectful for the people if he does not drink this time, so he had to drink. A beautiful girl brought that drink to him. Her name was Salima. She's the other main character of this movie. John looked at her and he liked her so much. They drank too much, and then Salima was dancing with her friends. Then everyone requested John to perform something for them. He told them a boring poem. The people didn't like it. Then the boy who came to pick him up danced with John. Everyone laughed at them so much. His name was Belansai. The next morning, John was so embarrassed about what he did last night. Today Henry brought Salima with him. Henry told John that she will work exactly as your wife. John didn't understand anything, but then Henry said it's so important to learn the local language and Salima will help you to learn the language. You will have sex with her, and this is the best way of learning language. It has been happening for centuries. John thought this was so wrong. He does not even know her, and he cannot do it. Henry told him, "We're not forcing her to have sex with you. She chose you." Henry was forcing John, and then John agreed, but he said, "I will not have sex with her." Henry got so angry at him and left. Salima was also angry at him because of what he said. Some Chinese people entered their border, and they fought with them. The local people killed those Chinese, but the king ordered them to bring their heads to him. John gave this job to Belansai, but Belansai brought a monkey's head. John didn't recognize it. Then everyone laughed at him so hard. John was new here, and no one took him seriously. John planned to do something about it. When he came back home, his chef brought a new guy. He said he was his nephew. "He can have sex with you." John refused to have sex with Salima, so the chef thought John was gay. John got so angry at him and said, "No, I will not tolerate it." He also fired Salima in anger. Salima also went outside. Chef told him, "If she leaves your room, then the people will think she's so ugly. They will make fun of her." Then John also went after her. He said, "We don't do this in our country. I can't have sex with someone like this." He said sorry to her and wanted to try the language once again. Salima also agreed with him. In the next scene, we saw that John came to Henry's house for some work. Then he met his wife, Aggie. Aggie asked him, "How's your sleeping dictionary?" Salima's profession is called sleeping dictionary. Aggie knew about it and she doesn't care about it. This is the tradition of this place, and that's why she accepted this. At night, John and Salima slept in the same room, but in different beds. Salima told him, "If you don't have sex with anyone else, then when you will get married, you will have zero experience about it." John made fun of it and said, "I will attend some classes about it." John asked her, "Why did you choose me?" Salima said, "You're different from the others." The next day, John went to meet the local people. They were still not listening to him. He was teaching some kids, but Belansai found no point in it. John told him, "I know you can stay underwater for so long. You're the champion of it." Belansai said, "Yes, I am." So now, John wants to do a competition with him. All the people were so excited about this. They went underwater. After some time, Belansai came out. But John was still underwater. Lastly, he came out and he became the winner. John had an oxygen cylinder with him. These people do not know what an oxygen cylinder is, so everyone got scared of it. John beat Balansai, so everyone started to listen to him. That night, Salima was teaching him from the children's book. Salima read him a poem, and this was the poem that John's father would tell him when he was a kid. Salima said, "My father also read this poem to me when I was a child." When she was 4 years old, her father died. While she was teaching him the language, she was also teaching him about hand, neck, feet, and other body parts. They started touching each other, and then had sex. After that, they were having sex so frequently. One night, after having sex, Salima was leaving, but John said, "No, sleep here in my bed." Salima said, "This is our tradition. If two men and women wake up together in the morning, they will get married. And you don't want to get married to me." The next night, Henry invited John over to his house. Henry's daughter came back from England after completing her education. They were having dinner together. Henry's daughter was named Cecil. Cecil was researching these local people in England. Then she said there were so many strange traditions in this place. If a new officer came there, they would get accompanied with a girl. Cecil didn't know that this tradition was still in practice. Cecil wondered if they would have any feelings between them. But Henry thinks it would be wrong for them to establish any feelings for each other in this manner, because this is just a tradition. John said they might develop some feelings for each other as he was developing for Salima. Henry found this so wrong. John came back home and kissed Salima. The next day, John and Cecil were working together. Cecil wanted to know more about these people. She was researching them. And that's why John was showing her all the places. She was taking pictures of those people. She came to Salima and took a photo of her. But Salima didn't like it. She asked John to tell her to stop. But John could not tell her to stop. Suddenly, some people came by the river on a boat. They died from a dangerous disease. What was happening here? John went with some people to investigate this. Salima and Balansai were also with him. Before they left, Aggie came to him and told him, "My daughter is so well educated and she's such a good girl. You'll be happy with her. You guys should marry each other." But John found it so strange. He was not responding about it. Then Aggie said, "Say yes or else she will get out of your hand." At night, John talked to Salima. He asked her, "Was there any officer like me who you slept with?" Salima said yes. John didn't protect her in front of Cecil, and that's why she was so angry at him. She said, "You are also like the others." John asked her, "Didn't you find something different in me? Is our relationship not different from the others?" Salima said, "No, I just sleep and have sex with you." John realized she was angry at him. The next day, they went to a place to investigate the disease. There were so many people infected by this disease, and many have died already. John didn't understand the reason behind this. Then someone attacked John and Balansai saw him, and he saved his life. Then they followed that guy. They found out that so many people were mining silver. John realized that they are the reason behind this disease. When he came back, he saw that Salima was also sick. Then John realized Salima had rice last time. The people who were mining there gave them rice to eat. If all of them die, no one will know about their mining. And Salima also ate this rice. But this is slow poison, and there's nothing to worry about. But the people who are eating this rice for a very long time will die from it. The local people here were so dangerous. If they found it out, they would kill them all. Balansai asked John if he should tell them the truth. Whatever those people did is so wrong, and that's why John gave them orders to kill them all. John realized he was so worried about Salima's sickness. He could not live without her. He told her all of this. He proposed to her to marry him. Salima said, "No one will allow us. This will be hard for us." John said, "No, the people will understand." When John talked about Salima with Henry, Henry became so angry. He said, "This is not allowed. This will be disrespectful toward our government." But John couldn't let her go. Then Aggie heard about it. Then Aggie told him, "Salima was your past, and you should move on." Henry gave him an offer. He told him, "You will go to England and get married there. And then, if you think about coming back here, you can come back anytime. But if you reject my offer, then I will put you in jail for killing those miners." For this, the tribe leader also blackmailed Salima that if she does not let him go, then the people will kill Balansai. Balansai requested her so much, but she didn't listen. So they put her in a cage. John came to her. Salima said, "I told you this is not possible." Henry gave a last chance to John and Salima. If they don't listen to them, then they will be put in jail. Salima does not want to see him in jail, so she said that I will never meet him again. Salima told him to go, and then we saw that 1 year has passed. John got married to Cecil. On their wedding night, Cecil asked John, "Did you have any Sleeping Beauty?" John told her the truth, but Cecil didn't care about it. John proposed to her to marry him. 1 year passed, so John decided to go there once again. When they reached there, they were welcomed by the people. John was about to teach all the kids. At night, they watched a movie together, but John was only looking for Salima amongst these people. Cecil noticed it. She wanted to have sex at night, but she was unable to shake off this thought. So she told him, "I know everything about you and Salima. Now she's married. She also has a son. She's so happy with her life." Cecil also wanted John to be happy with her. John assured her that he is happy with her. The next day, John went to see his old house. There was another officer with another sleeping dictionary. The name of this officer was Neville. John noticed that Neville beat his sleeping dictionary so badly. John became so angry at him. He threatened him that if he hurts him once again, he will cut off his private parts at night. Since Cecil and John came here, Aggie was observing them. She thinks the relationship between John and Cecil is not quite right. When they were talking about this, John heard it. He came in and kissed Cecil. He asked Aggie to leave the room. One day, when John was near the river, he saw Salima and her son. Her son was white, which means he was John's son. He was so shocked and wanted to meet her. Then he talked with his chef to arrange a meeting. But the chef has already talked to Salima, and she does not want to talk to him at all. But they called her in. Then John told her, "He's my son. I should meet him." Salima said, "If the people see us together, they will kill us." John said, "Please, let me see him." He met his son and sang him the song his father sang for him. The next day, he was making a toy for his son. Aggie confronted John about this and understood everything. Aggie said, "My husband Henry also had a sleeping dictionary. I was scared that he would go back to her, and that's why I stayed with him for 30 years. And I won't let this happen to my daughter." She warned him to end his relationship with Salima, but John didn't take this seriously. He started to spend time with Salima and his son. When Balansai found it out, he got so angry at him. One night, he went to John's room to kill him, but John woke up, and this time he was safe. This was a very serious incident. That's why Henry said, "Now we should kill Balansai. Salima was your past. You should have left her." John said, "If you had another daughter like Salima, would you let her go?" Henry said it would be the appropriate thing to do. Then he was watching Salima, which means Salima is Henry's daughter. Henry never got to meet his daughter because of his wife. In the next scene, we saw Balansai was arrested. Henry told his force to sentence him to death. They were about to hang him the next day. But one time, Balansai saved John's life. At night, Henry went there and let him go and told him to go far away from here. At night, Salima also came to meet him. John said, "If we want to stay together, then we will have to run away from here." Then they decided on a date to run away from here. Henry was so angry at him about this. Aggie wanted to teach him a lesson, and that's why she told Salima to sleep with Neville as his sleeping dictionary. She blackmailed her, "If she doesn't do it, she will put her in jail." Tonight they were about to run away, but before that, Cecil came to John and told him she's pregnant. She was so happy today. Then John got so confused about what he should do now. At night, when Neville and Salima were alone, Neville started forcing her. Salima beat him so badly, and finally, with the help of the chef, she killed Neville. If she didn't do it, he would hurt her so bad, and he would never let her go. On the other side, John was writing a letter. He could not run away with her because of Cecil, but Cecil found it out. She read the letter and talked to him. She said, "My mom was afraid, and that's why she always stayed with my father. They were never fully happy. I can see that I'm not your first choice. Still, you don't give me that much priority. Salima was your first love, and you should go to her. I don't want to stay with a man who doesn't love me with his full heart." Cecil was hopeful that she would find someone else. She let him go, but John was late because of this incident. Salima thought John would not come tonight. She was so heartbroken. John reached the place, but he was late. He could not find her. The chef was keeping an eye on Salima for John. He said, "She's still here. Salima had killed Neville, and that's why Henry was looking for her. Henry found her, but instead of arresting her, he gave his gun to Salima. She is his daughter, and he does not want anything bad to happen to her." Selena also hugged him. She always knew.